So you feel fat, but you're not fat. What exactly is going on here? Well, this is just another form of body dysmorphia. Similar to the person who always thinks they're small when in fact they're the biggest and most jacked guy in their gym, or the people turn their heads to look at them. It's the same thing for you, except now it's the opposite. You believe that you're fat, you're obese, you're this, you're that, when in reality, you're probably healthy and decently lean, nice and trim, nothing to worry about. So the state of mind that you're experiencing is delusional. And in this video, I will prove why that's the case, and hopefully it can make you realize how good you actually have it. So let's break it down. First of all, I want to bring to your attention that the online fitness community and social media in general has skewed our perceptions of what it actually means to be lean. I think this is one of the greatest problems we have. The thing is, you are exposed to excellence every single day. The best naturals with the greatest genetics. People who are shredded to the bone. Reuters who are willing to do whatever it takes to reach the pinnacle of physical development. Fake naturals, the best athletes, essentially, you're used to seeing the best of the best, okay? Now, that could be good for some people, give them motivation, inspire them to reach even higher levels. But for some of you who already have body dysmorphia, it's only going to make things worse. And it can lead you down a path that you don't want to go to. Now, in reference to being lean, this is probably the most delusional thing I've ever seen in the fitness community. This idea that if you don't have like shredded abs, you're fat. And I see this all the time on social media. I'll see a guy, he takes a selfie of himself, you know, and you could see some ab definition, not crazy there, but you could see it. He's like, man, I'm fat. I got to get back hardcore on my diet. I got to get lean again. And it's like, what? You're already lean. Or someone has a completely flat stomach. There's no bulge whatsoever. They have a good height to waist ratio. But then they look at themselves and like, eh, I'm lacking definition. Or they look in the mirror, I'm lacking striations. I'm lacking veins. It's like everybody wants to go for the extremes. Now, if you don't fall into the extremity of being lean, what comes after that? Well, the extremity of being fat. It's either you're lean or you're fat. Or you're shredded or you're fat. There's no in-betweens. And that's a delusion, and I feel that the fitness community really distorts your perception, especially when we have all these drug users who are sub 10% body fat year-round with big muscles, okay? So we need to establish the fact that you don't have to be shredded to the bone to be lean, okay? Even 50% body fat is an excellent, excellent, excellent range, and no doctor's going to tell you that you're unhealthy for that. If you want to look what obesity really looks like, take a look outside. The majority of the population is overweight. We are in the middle of an obesity epidemic. This is one of the greatest tragedies of the modern day age. Obesity is everywhere. And then you have a guy like yourself who has visible abs to an extent, and you're like, oh man, I'm fat. When there's a guy who's actually fat, and he's about to die, and he's taking a bunch of medications, and his quality of life has suffered. In what ways has your quality of life suffered as a result of having a little bit of ab definition? What, because you're not getting enough likes on Instagram? Come on, bro. It's a delusional way of viewing things. You're not fat. You're probably healthy. The way I see it, 20% body fat should be the max that you want to reach. But if you're under 20%, you shouldn't be too hard on yourself. Now, everybody has goals. You're allowed to be lean. That's all good. But you don't have to be shredded to the bone, certainly, okay? And I would say 15 is an excellent range for looking lean, for looking badass as a whole, okay? And if you're 12% body fat, that's also cool. You're not fat just because you're not shredded, okay? Let's get that straight. Another thing about social media is the way that these pictures are likely taken. It's under good lighting conditions, okay, which most of you will not have access to, in addition to having an amazing pump and great camera angles. Let's establish something. When you take a selfie in the mirror, that's not the best way of looking good. You need someone else to take the picture of you, okay, with a proper camera. The thing is, a lot of these cameras are not of the best quality, okay, and even if they are, the lens is distorted. So your head's going to look a little bit bigger than your body when it's not supposed to be that way. It can distort little things of your physique. That's why if you take a professional photo done, right, on a real freaking camera with something like an 85 millimeter lens, you can see what your face actually looks like in the real world. But if you take it on a fisheye lens, something like an 18 millimeter, your face looks freaking weird, your nose looks bigger, it distorts the way you actually look. And you can test this out yourself, man. Take a picture of yourself with the phone really close to your face, look what happens. Or take it where you're standing on the other side of the room, all right, with that same phone. You'll see you look infinitely better in the face, okay? And the same thing for the body. A lot of these guys hire people, okay? They hire photographers, they hire the best of the best to get the best photographs. And most of these guys at the top, not only are they taking roids, using the best angles and lighting, but they have other people taking the shots for them. And even if they are taking selfies, it's usually gonna be done with a nice camera, or they do it in such a way where it does look good. But understand that in ordinary conditions, that's not how it's gonna be, okay? Ordinary conditions is you in a fully relaxed state, not flexing any muscle groups. And I can tell you that even if you're lean, all right, you're not going to look shredded to the freaking bone 24/7. You just won't. But you're not going to look like these guys on Instagram doing all these crazy poses and stuff. Truth, especially if you have average genetics. And the lighting thing is so key. You take out the good lighting and you're left with like a softer looking physique. Real talk, man. You can be lean. You can be 10% body fat. If you have bad lighting, man, it makes you look like you're 15% easy. So lighting can change a game 100%. And most of what you see on Instagram is people taking good pictures under good lighting and even flexing and all that, okay? So I think that covers a pretty good amount of information regarding the online fitness community, okay? It's wrong and it's not representing what's actually going on. You're not fat, okay? Secondly, you should be aware that past experiences delude you, okay? Most skinny people, for example, always want to be big because they never want to go back to that state of being small, all right? And when they actually do hit an amazing physique, it's like they still see that skinny guy in the mirror to a certain extent. Obviously, they improve, but they still see him, even though it's not there. If you look at some before and after pictures, it's clearly not there. Now, the same thing applies to fatter people. Ever notice how some guys, they're going to lose 100 pounds, and they might lose 100 pounds or even 200 pounds, depending how obese the person was. And then all of a sudden, it's like they never want to get fat ever again. And they start going really crazy with the diet, very obsessive. And if they gain even a little bit of fat, it destabilizes them, right? Well, that might be you. For some of you who were formerly fat, maybe you were a fat kid or you were fat majority of your life and you cut down, you're fearful of gaining that weight back. And when you do see a little bit of chub or anything like that, it puts you in a negative state of mind. Now, the thing is, if you're in a healthy body fat range, you shouldn't be experiencing these feelings of, damn, I'm fat. No, it shouldn't be happening, bro. If you look in the mirror, you should see someone who is trim, someone who went through this amazing weight loss transformation. And if anything, you should be inspired. But that's not the way it works because you were formerly fat for a long period of time. So I understand that mentality. I was a skinny guy myself. Just see opposite situation here. So you have to be realistic about what actually happened. And the best thing I could tell you, man, is to look at those older pictures. Just like I talked about in my last video on bigorexia, you only appreciate how lean you are when you look back at the past, okay? So look at those pictures when you weigh 300 pounds and now you're 180 lean. Look at that, man, and realize how far you've come. And that'll put things into a greater perspective. Maybe look at some of your older pants if you still have access to them. Try wearing them. See how freaking loose it feels around the waist, okay? Look at the body measurements. Look at those old shirts you used to wear. Look at the past. Get a blast in the past to see how far you come, okay? A lot of times it's delusional thinking. You think you're fat now when in fact you're a good body fat percentage, okay? And like I said, 15 is a great range. You don't have to be shredded to the bone. Just flat stomach is more than enough. Or just having a little bit of ab definition, you're fine, okay? That's not fat. The next thing I want to talk about is the body mass index and how it will be skewed for serious lifters. So if you're under the impression that you're fat because that number is higher than it should be, assess how jacked you actually are. It's probably not the leanness. In fact, there are skinny fat people, people who are higher in body fat percentage compared to you, who have a better BMI, okay? Why? Because they're lacking muscle mass. If you put on 20 pounds of muscle, that's going to skew the numbers big time. And if you're 15% body fat, bro, it's going to put you up there, okay? So if you're a serious lifter, your BMI is going to be higher, and that's just the truth. So a better way of assessing how fat you are is to look at your height-to-waist ratio, all right? That's how you do it, height-to-waist. If you have a smaller waist, good job. If your waist is freaking large like crazy, then you're not doing something too right, okay? Or look at the bulge of your stomach. If your stomach is popping out like crazy, that's a bad sign. If you have a flat stomach, you're good. If you have a bit of abs, that's good. If you have even more abs, congratulations. But you can have ripped abs and still have a higher body mass index if you're a serious lifter, okay? That's why I'm saying we have to assess things from a realistic perspective. Look in the goddamn mirror. Are you lean? Are you leaner than most people who walk the streets? Most of you are, actually. You'd be surprised, okay? So don't think you're fat just because of that number, all right? Would it be better to have a lower BMI? Probably, yeah. But don't beat yourself up over it if you're already decently healthy, if you're in a decent body fat already. It's just the muscle mass that's distorting you. So this idea that it's because of the fat, it's not true, it's the muscle. On a final note, I would invite all of you to view the athletes who compete in different sports. You'll start to see a trend that most of them are not shredded. It's just the truth. Some of your best athletes, some of the ones who are making the most amount of money, some of the ones that everybody loves, the most popular, not shredded. They might have a six pack, they might be decently lean. But a lot of these guys are 15% body fat, 12 to 15, a large percentage of them, yeah. Most are not 10% or less, just the truth. Very few are below 10% body fat. And what do normal people perceive these people to be? Lean as hell, in shape, trim. Because it is trim, that's the truth. If you're 12 to 15% body fat, you're not fat, okay? That's YouTube fat, which is a delusional state of being, okay? It's craziness that people even call that fat. That's madness. But in the real world, guess what? That's normal. There's nothing wrong about that. And it's not because everybody else is fat. It's because, no, this is actually a healthy range. Look at athletes who compete in very different sports, and you'll very clearly see that most of them are not shredded to the bone. And the thing is, too, they're not using all these crazy lighting advantages. They're filmed with good cameras, obviously, but they don't have the best lighting, okay? They're not doing posing, not doing anything like that. Some are just competing, doing their thing, and they look good, you know? So once you understand that it really is the online fitness community, general and bodybuilding and all that, it gives you a more realistic perspective as to how you actually stand. So stop stressing so much. If you're not fat, you're not fat. Now, if you are, then do something about it, you know? Get in a lean state. But once you hit that state, don't beat yourself up over the fact that you're not having shredded abs, you know, or that you don't look as good as some other dude. So be realistic, man. Are you actually fat or not? Like, seriously, be realistic, okay? So that said, I hope this video helped out some of you, man. Give me your feedback down below, and I'll talk to you all next time.